Guys, in last session we discussed about the some example based on a motion relativity. In today's session we are going to discuss one special case which is related to motion under gravity, means for constant accelerating motion. Okay, let's start with this first one. So that is a simple theory, Galileo's law of odd numbers. So this is one theory which is useful to solve out the different problems. Okay. And this theory, actually, whatever we have proved here, that is example number 3.6. It is a textbook illustration number. Textbook illustration number 3.6. Okay, let's start. The distance traversed during the equal interval of time. Equal interval of time means each time interval is 1 second, maybe. Each time interval you consider 2 second. Time interval is same. All this time interval is 1 second, all this time interval 2 second, 3 second, let's see. By the body falling from rest means initial velocity is what? Zero. The stand to another in the same ratio as the odd number being this being with a unity. So we give this ratio of this distance, that is a 1:3:5:7 and so on. Okay, that's a simple rule. Now let's you understand properly. If you consider this situation, see, suppose here is the some initially body is somewhere here, initial. Now this body is falling from this position and it is moved towards the ground. It is moved towards the ground like this. And so suppose that body is dropped at t is equal to 3 seconds. At t is equal to 1 second, suppose body is somewhere here. At t is equal to 2 seconds, suppose body is somewhere here. At t is equal to 3 seconds, suppose body is somewhere here. Means each we just consider interval of time is 1 second, 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and so on. So if you finding out this ratio of this whole distance covered in this one, means this whole distance. See, this suppose s1, s2, s3, and so on. Then this rules is given like this. s1:2, s2:2, s3 and so on is equal to 1:3:5:7, like this. Okay, now let's see just give this proof. So what is this s1? So see, initial velocity is zero. Initial velocity is what? Zero. So what is s1? S1 is a distance covered. S1 is a distance covered in first second. So S1 is equal to V0t plus 1/2 at t square. We just write the values only. Okay, so this answer is what? Zero. So actually, what is S1? S1 is equal to 1/2 at t square. S1 is what? 1/2 at t square. So what is the answer actually? See, 1/2 a means what here? G. We write only magnitudes. We write only magnitude. We are not considering the direction. Okay, into t square. So t means how much time is required? 1 second. So into 1 square. So answer is what? g/2 is equal to what? 5 meter. Now what is s1 plus s2? So answer is what? s1 is equal to g/2. Or you? Why I am writing this value 5 meter? Because in a free falling body. Covered a 5 meter distance in first second. That is a very important note. All of you guys, write now this, write down this important note. Important note. What is this important note? Free falling body cover a 5 meter distance in first second. Okay, in first second after falling, any free falling body is covered a 5 meter distance. That is a very important note and which is useful for us. If you just release any objects into the air, then how much distance covered in a first second? The answer is what? 5 meter. 5 meter distance is covered in a first second. Okay, so not this one. Okay, let's see. Let's count this s1 plus s2. So s1 plus s2, that is 1/2 g t square. But t is what? That's total time is what? From here to here, here to here 1 second, but here to here total 2 seconds. So that's answer is what? 2 square. Answer is what? 2 square. So it is actually what? 4g/2. What is this actually? 4g/2. So what is s2 from here? So s2 is equal to 4g by 2 minus s1. So s1 is what? G by 2, 4g minus g. So 3g by 2. So answer is what? S2 is equal to 3g by 2. Okay. Similar way, you finding out this s1 plus s2 plus s3. This total distance. First, this total distance. Okay. So what is this total distance? Total time is what? 3 seconds. So answer is what? 1 half g into 3 square. So answer actually what? 9g by 2. So from this, what is s3? So s3 is equal to 9g by 2 minus s2 minus s1. So 9g by 2 minus s3. Sorry, minus s2. 3g by 2 minus s1 g by 2. So you just calculate this answer. So what is this answer? S3 is equal to 9 minus 4. 9 minus 4, this what? 5. So that is a 5g by 2. So you take the ratio. See, if you take the ratio and so on, you just finding out this type of data, s4, s5, s6 and so on, then you just taking this ratio s1 is to s2 is to s3 and so on is equal to g by 2 is to 3g by 2 is to 5g by 2 and so on. So if you taking this ratio, g by 2 is cancelled out from each one. So 1 is to 3 is to 5 and so on. It means this is equal to 1 is to 3 is to 5 and so on. So this ratio is same during the, if the time interval same for any time interval, you consider this 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, this ratio is in this form, 1 is to 3 is to 5. That is called odd number. See, odd number ratios, 1, 3, 5, 7. So we call it is Galileo's law of odd numbers. Due to this one, due to this reason, we call it is Galileo's odd numbers. Galileo's law of odd numbers. Okay. So by this way, if you want to finding out this distance for free falling body, okay. So for free falling, only for free falling body, if you find this ratio, then how you get this answer? See, suppose that t is equal to 0, t is equal to 1, t is equal to 2 second, t is equal to 3 second and so on. Then here consider this y is equal to 0 meter, then at 1 second that is what? 5 meter. At 2 second, what is this distance? 5 meter means which one is the 5 meter actually? You must be remember. This distance s1, s2, s3 and so on. So if you count this all these distances, then this is equal to what? 5 meter. So this distance is 3 times of the 5 meter. So 5 into 3 is what? 15 meter. So this distance is 5 times of the 5 meter. So 5 into 5 is equal to what? 25 meter. If you consider the 4 second, then next one is what? So this ratio for free falling body is what? 5, then 15, then 25 meter. Write down this meter also. Only for free falling body. For 1 second. Free falling body, time interval 1 second. Free falling body, time interval is what? 1 second. Okay, you must be right here. Time interval 1 second. So our answer is what actually? 5 meter, uske baad 15 meter, then 25 meter, then 35 meter, then 45 meter and so on. So by this way you get this answer. So s1, so this is represents s1, s2, s3, s4, s5 and so on. You must be remember this diagram is most important to solve out this problem. Okay, so all of you guys note this in your books properly. This diagram we use to solve out the different problem. So this law is known as a Galileo's odd numbers law. This law is named as a Galileo's odd number. Okay, note it. Let's see. So this is the rule. This is the rule. And from the textbook, that is the illustration number 3.6. So for any body, if any body is moving horizontally, see, it's also apply for horizontal body. If any body is moving horizontally with a constant acceleration a, and its initial speed is what? Zero. Then you suppose consider this body is moving from here to here. Time is what? Suppose 2 seconds. From here to here, time is what? Suppose 4 seconds. From here to here, time is what? Suppose 6 seconds. And this distance are given to you. X1, X2, X3. Then you give the answer here also. X1 is to X2 is to X3 is equal to 1 is to 3 is to 5 and so on. Do you understand? Why? See, time interval is same. 2 seconds, 2 seconds, 2 seconds. 0 to 2, 2 seconds. 2 to 4, 2 seconds. 4 to 6, 2 seconds. So time interval is same. Acceleration is same throughout the motion. Initial speed is zero. These are the three requirements to apply this rule. First requirement is what? Acceleration constant. Second requirement is what? Time interval is same. And third requirement is what? Initial velocity zero. So if this condition is satisfied in any constant accelerating motion, then you apply this Galileo's rule. So here also, this distance x1, s2 and x3 are in the form of ratio 1 is to 3 is to 5. Okay, so this law is also applicable for the constant horizontal motion as well as free falling body. For any free falling body, you apply this rule. Okay, let's come back to the study. So that is a Galileo's rule of distances, the ratio of distances in case of free fall. The ratio of distances in case of free fall. Simple one. Here we want a distance ratio. In 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, and so on. Okay, so if a free fall means what? Initial velocity zero. So distance covered by the body during the free fall is what? D is equal to 1/2 gt². D is equal to 1/2 gt². So distance covered in 1 second is what? 1/2 g² Distance covered in 2 second. What answer? 1/2 g² Distance covered in 3 seconds. So d3 is equal to 1/2 g³² and so on. As we say, find kar sakte total distance. Okay, so what is this answer? So actually this ratio d1 is to d2 is to d3 is a t1² is to t2² is to t3². So our answer is what? Ratio of distance covered in 1 second, 2 second, 3 second from this one. From this one we give this answer d1 is to d2 is to d3 and so on. And so on is equal to what? 1 is to 2² 4 is to 3² 9 and so on. Means 1² 2² 3² 4² 5² and what I am finding here, see, you must be remember, that's the initial position. Suppose object is somewhere here initially, then object is 1 second somewhere here, 2 second somewhere here, t is equal to 2, t is equal to 1, t is equal to 3. So that is d1. This one is d2. This one is d3. I am just finding out this ratio of the total distances. In this first case, in this case, ratio of the distances, but covered in a particular time interval. And here this one is the ratio of the, that is the ratio of the distance covered in a some time interval. Okay, sorry, in a total time, 1 second, then 2 second, then 3 second, then 4 second. Isme kitna distance covered total? ठीक है. सो अगर S1 S2 लिखना चाहते हैं ऐसे लिखना पड़ेगा. देखो S1 S2 S3. सो इसका रेशियो 1 इज टू 3 इज टू 5 आता है. लेकिन D1 D2 D3 का रेशियो क्या आता है? 1:4:9. यू मस्ट बी रिमेंबर. व्हाई? ओनली फॉर फ्री फॉलिंग बॉडी. ओनली फॉर फ्री फॉलिंग बॉडी डिस्टेंस इज गिवन एज अ 1/2 gt². सो 1/2 g कैंसिल आउट इन ईच केस. सी 1/2 g 1/2 g 1/2 g कैंसिल आउट इन ईच केस. सो आंसर इज व्हाट? 1 is to 4 is to 9 is to 4 square 16 is to 5 square 25 and so on. Okay, so you just finding this answer by this way. That is also applicable in horizontal case. Let's see. Suppose you just apply the same rule for the horizontal motion, then object is here, initial speed is zero and it is moving with constant acceleration. Then at t is equal to 1 second, object is here. T is equal to 2 second, object is here. T is equal to 3 second, object is here. Then this distance is considered as a d1, that is d2, this one is d3. Then d1 is to d2 is to d3 is equal to 1 is to 4 is to 9. You must be remember. And if you want this answer, S1, S2, S3, means इतना ही डिस्टेंस, तो फिर आंसर क्या आएगा? S1 is to S2 is to S3 is equal to 1 is to 3 is to 1 is to 3 is to 5. Do you understand what is the difference between these two? So by this way you get the answer. Okay, all of you guys note this, then after we are just solve some example. Okay, note it. Let's see first example, practice example number one. A body falls from a height 200. Find the ratio of distance traveled during each 2 seconds. Means time interval is same. If the time interval same and body is falls, falls means initial velocity is what? Zero from the height 2 meter. So during this journey from t is equal to 0 to 6 seconds. So let's consider the body is somewhere here, at and the ground is somewhere here. Okay, and this body starts falling. So it's falling from here to here. Consider t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 2 seconds. Then again it's falling from here to here. T is equal to 4 seconds. From here to here, suppose t is equal to 6 seconds and so on. So we have to finding out this ratio. So initial speed is what? 0. This one is what? S1. This is S2. This is S3. So answer is simple. S1 is 2. S2 is 2. S3 is equal to 1 is 2. 3 is 2. 5. Directly use the Galileo's rule. So write down the answer. 3 is 2. 3 is 2. 5. By using Galileo's law of odd number. Okay, so by using this law we give this answer. This ratio of the distance is what? 1 is to 3 is to 5. Why? See, 2 seconds doesn't matter, time interval is important here. Time interval same hai, to aap ye rule apply kar sakte ho, theek hai? So all of you guys note this example in your books, then after we go to this next one. Okay, note it. Okay, practice example number 2. See, a person sitting on the top of a tall building dropping a ball at the regular interval of 1 second. मतलब 1 second के interval में ball है drop कर रहा है. Drop करना है मतलब initial speed is 0. Dropping means what? V0 is equal to 0. Just dropping the ball. Find the position of 3rd, 4th, and 5th ball when the 6th ball is being to dropped. That's very simple. Consider that is a very tall tower. So this is what actually very tall tower. Now one person is sitting somewhere here. So here one person. Okay, and this person is drops the different balls. So for when he dropping a ball, let's say draw some position that is a first ball, and he just try to drop the 6th ball. So first ball, consider that is a 2nd ball, 3rd ball, 4th ball, 5th ball, and that is what? 6th ball. Now 6th ball is try to drop down. So we have to finding out the position of 3rd, 4th and 5th ball. So that's exactly you apply this rule here. We apply the Galileo's rule here. So what is this total distance? So first distance we must be know, that is what? 5 meter. Second distance 3 times of this, so that is what? 15 meter. Then next distance is what? 5 times of the first one, so 5 into 5, 25 meter. Then next one is 1 is to 3 is to 5. You miss this distance. S1 is to S2 is to S3 is to S4 is to S5 is what? 1 is to 3 is to 5 is to 7 is to 9 and so on. Okay. So first distance we know how much, that is a 5 meter. So second distance is 5 times of this one. Sorry, 3 times of this one. So 5 into 3, 15 meter. Third distance is what? 5 times of the first distance. So 5 into 5, 25 meter. Fourth distance is what? 7 times of the initial distance. 7 into 5, 35 meter, and then one is a 9 time, 9 into 5 is a 45 meter. So let's write all these distances. So first one is 5 meter, second one is 15, third one is 25, this fourth one is what, 35 meter, this one is what, 45 meter. Now which one you want? So you want a position of third ball. So where is the third ball? See, where is the third ball? You just see. So third ball is somewhere here. Here we want this total distance. So what is this position of third ball? So 5 plus 15 plus, so this is the position of third ball. Okay, this line. So 5 plus 15 plus 25. Similarly, what is the position of fourth ball? This one, see, where is the fourth ball? Somewhere here. So that is the position of fourth ball, and this one is the position of fifth ball. So let's be finding out this all the thing. So position of third ball. What is this position of the third ball? So 25 plus 15 plus 5. So you just count it. So 25 plus 5, 30. 30 plus 15 means 45 meter. So this answer is what? 45 meter. Similarly, position of fourth ball is what? So fourth ball is where? Where is the fourth ball? Somewhere here. So that's total 15 plus 5. So that's equal to 15 plus 5. So what is answer? 20 meter. And position of fifth ball, what is this? Simple, this one, this one. Okay, so answer is what? Fifth ball ka only 5 meter. So our answer is what? 45, 20 and 5 meter. By this way you getting this answer. For us, this you must be right. For us, this one is S1, this is S2, this is S3, it is S4, S5. Okay, for us this are the distance. That's here, that doesn't matter. The ball is dropped, stone is dropped, anything is dropped. This ratio is in the form of 1 is to 3 is to 5, like this. So you just compare, count this distance by using this one. In a first second, see here we want a 1 second, so we are using this relation, otherwise we are not use relation. Okay, for first second of the free bowling body, how much distance is covered? 5 meter. In a first second, how much distance is covered? 5 meter. Okay, all of you guys note this example in your books. So its answer is what? 45, 20 and 5 meter. See here the answer is given to us. Okay, now let's come to this next example. Example number three. A stone is thrown vertically upward with a speed of 40 meter per second, and second time the stone is thrown vertically upward with a speed of 80 meter per second. Find the ratio of the velocity of the 1 second before it reaches the maximum height in this both cases. Very different example. See, suppose it is a ground. You understand it properly. Okay, now this first ball is thrown upward with a 40 meter per second, and the second ball is thrown upward with a 80 meter per second, means second time. So this first ball is reached up to some maximum height somewhere here, let's consider. Okay, and this one is reached somewhere here up to the maximum height. So we just count before it. So when it reaches the maximum height, matlab ye ball jab maximum height pe rahega to fir wahan pe speed kya hogi? Zero. So wo return bhi aayega aise, ye bhi return aayega aise. So return motion kaise hogi? What is the return motion? Return motion is like a free falling body. If you just throw the any objects into the upward direction, it come back like a free fall body. Because why? Because at this height the speed is what? Zero. So whatever the speed, so after 1 second objects is reached somewhere here. So before 1 second objects is the same position. So this speed in upward direction, the same speed is in downward direction. So this speed is suppose v1, this is also what? V1. Exactly similar. यहाँ पे भी क्या होगा? जब ball यहाँ पे आएगा return में 1 second के बाद, तो इस पहुँचने पहले भी 1 second वहीं पे होगा, ठीक है? तो मतलब यहाँ पे जो speed होगी, suppose v2 है, तो ये भी speed क्या होगी? V2 होगी. You must be understand. Okay. If you just throw the ball upward side and coming back, the speed is same for the similar height, like this. ओके, तो इसको क्या बोल सकते हैं? V1 एंड V1 है, ठीक है? That's V1 एंड V1, this both are same. V2 एंड V2 both are same. So we have to finding out the ratio वी वन अपॉन वी टू इज, ये अपना क्वेश्चन है. सो नाउ हियर फर्स्ट वी अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज आर क्वेश्चन एक्चुअली. सो क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट, फाइंड द रेशियो वी वन अपॉन वी टू. इन दिस बोथ केस बिफोर, एक्चुअली बिफोर फाइंड करना है, बट आफ्टर फाइंड करोगे तो वो क्या होगा, सेम ही रहेगा. आफ्टर क्या होगा, वो सेम ही रहेगा, ठीक है. पर फिर वी वन और वी टू की वैल्यू क्या आएगी, मतलब ये तो यहाँ से फ्री फॉल की जैसे ही कंडीशन है, ये भी यहाँ से फ्री फॉल की जैसे ही कंडीशन है, और दोनों फ्री फॉल ही है. सो फ्री फॉल के फर्स्ट सेकेंड में आंसर क्या होता है, सो वी वन का आंसर क्या होगा, वी वन इज इक्वल टू वी जीरो प्लस जी टी, और वी टू का आंसर भी क्या होगा, वी जीरो प्लस जी टी. ओके, सो एक्चुअली इफ यू यूजिंग द साइन देन हियर माइनस जी टी. नाउ वी जीरो, वी जीरो बोथ आर जीरो बिकॉज हियर ऑल्सो इनिशियल स्पीड जीरो, हियर ऑल्सो इनिशियल स्पीड जीरो. आप ऊपर जाने की वजह से नीचे आने का सोचो, मतलब यू जस्ट कंसिडर द मोशन वेन दिस बॉल इज कमिंग बैक, बिकॉज दस बोथ द स्पीड इज सेम, बोथ द स्पीड इज सेम, ओनली द डायरेक्शन इज डिफरेंट. इन दिस अपवर्ड, इन दिस फर्स्ट केस अपवर्ड मोशन, आफ्टर आफ्टर रीचिंग द मैक्सिमम इज कम बैक, आफ्टर रीचिंग द मैक्सिमम इट्स कम बैक. तो डिफरेंस क्या है, अपवर्ड और डाउनवर्ड का डिफरेंस है, मतलब उसकी डायरेक्शन डिफरेंट है. वैल्यू तो कैसे रहेगी, सेम ही रहेगी. दोनों में कितना टाइम लगता है, इसमें भी वन सेकेंड है, इसमें भी वन सेकेंड है. तो मतलब कि वी वन इज इक्वल टू वॉट, वी टू, दिस रेशियो इज वॉट, वी वन अपॉन वी टू इज इक्वल टू वन इज टू वन. यू मस्ट बी अंडरस्टैंड, आप किसी भी स्पीड से कोई भी ऑब्जेक्ट को अपर डायरेक्शन में थ्रो कर रहे हो, तो फिर वो लास्ट सेकेंड में तो कितना डिस्टेंस कवर होगा, ए डिस्टेंस कितना होगा, 5 मीटर, ए डिस्टेंस भी कितना होगा, 5 मीटर, ये भी आपको नोट करना है. उसकी स्पीड भी कितनी होगी, जी टी इंटू जी टी, मीन्स 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड. व्हाट इज द स्पीड, वी वन की स्पीड क्या होगी, 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड, ये वी टू भी क्या होगा, 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड. आप वैल्यू रख के फाइंड कर सकते हो, देखो इसमें वैल्यू रखो तो वी वन इज इक्वल टू माइनस 10 इंटू 1, V2 is equal to minus 10 into 1. तो आंसर क्या है, minus 10 meter per second. Minus 10 meter per second. Minus क्या है, downward direction. But in the left hand side, this one case. In this one, see, here, see. This one. Upward direction, here upward direction. If you count this V1 and V2, then it's plus. If you count this V1 and V2, then it is a minus. There is no difference. There is a no difference. You just count like this. Okay, and you get the final answer. Clear? That's clear to all of you. And by this way you get the answer. What is answer? 1:1. A distance ka pucha hai to, a distance bhi 5 meter, a distance bhi 5 meter. Matlab last second mein agar aap kisi bhi objects ko upward direction mein throw karte ho, to last second mein jo velocity hai wo same rahegi, last second mein jo distance cover karta hai wo bhi same rahega. That's a additional note. Last second mein jo bhi distance cover kiya hai, that's a last second. See, that is what? लास्ट सेकेंड ऑफ दिस मोशन एंड दैट इज द लास्ट सेकेंड ऑफ दिस मोशन, लास्ट सेकेंड में सेम रहेगा. ओके, सो हियर यू मस्ट बी राइट अवन नॉट इफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट इज थ्रोन इन अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन देन द डिस्टेंस covered in last second. But which last second? Last second means what? Before, 1 second before. Last second means what? 1 second before reaches the maximum height. Okay? You must be noted. If any object is thrown in upward direction, then distance covered in last second. But which last second? You मतलब यहाँ पे last second का meaning क्या संबंध है? 1 second before reaches the maximum height is same. और कितना होता है? D is equal to 5 meter. Velocity भी कितनी होती है? So velocity v1 upon v2 is equal to what? 1:1. तो ये theoretical questions है. मतलब आपको ये theory याद रखनी है, ठीक है? क्यों याद रखें, क्योंकि समटाइम्स थ्योरिकल क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग टू यू डायरेक्टली गिव्स द आंसर. ओके, सो बाय दिस वे यू जस्ट गेटिंग दिस आंसर. ओके, ऑल ऑफ यू गाइस नॉट दिस, देन आफ्टर वी आर गो टू दिस नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल. नॉट इट, लेट्स सी नेक्स्ट वन, एग्जांपल नंबर फोर. एग्जांपल नंबर फोर, अ वाटर ड्रॉप्स आर फॉलिंग फ्रॉम द water tap at a regular interval of time. Underline this one, at a regular interval of time. Height of the tap from the ground is 5 meter. Means the situation is like this. See, here the tap. Okay, and suppose here the ground. So tap is falling from this one. Okay, and this height is how much? It is given 5 meter. It is given a 5 meter. When the first drop is reaches the ground, and the fifth drop is just falling from the tap. So means the situation is like this. When this fifth drop is somewhere here, at that time first drop is reaches the ground. Okay, the first. So let's see, draw the all this drop. So first, second, third, fourth. So this all this drop, first drop, second drop, third drop, fourth and fifth. So these are the different drop. So find the position of third drop. Find the position of third drop from the ground. Means we have to find this one. That is the third drop. This is third drop. So from the ground, iski height kya hogi? So this height is equal to what? So we have to find this one. Height is equal to, suppose x, then x is equal to what? As a finger. So that's quite difficult to finding out. This is quite difficult to finding out. But if you use this law, then it is quite easy. Why? The ratio of this distance, see, S1, S2, S3, S4. The ratio of this distance is, that's a known value. The ratio of this distance are known value. What is S1? S1 is a, S1 is to S2 is to S3 is S2, S3, S4. That's 1 is to 3 is to 5 is to 7. Okay, you just compare this answer with the free falling body. If you compare this answer with the free falling body, then your ratio doesn't change. Your ratio does not change. So let's we just draw the free falling body. So that is, here we draw a free falling body. If you draw the situation of free falling body, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 5, then we are using this 5. Okay, so let's we write down this all this answer. So first distance is how much? 5 meter. So it's exactly we use the same number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is only the reference data. Okay, ratio is same. Second one is what? 15 meter. Third one is what? 15, and then 25 meter. This one is what? 35 meter. Okay, so you count this ratio. Here what is S1, S2, S3? So that is S1, S2, S3, S4. So we just count this distance. What you have to want here? We want this one. We want this one. So you compare this both situations. Both are exactly similar in terms of ratio. These are exact, distance are different, but in terms of ratio, this is the same. If I am writing this value, then your idea will see 1/2 is equal to, maybe you write 3/6, maybe you write 4/8, maybe you write 5/10, maybe you write 6/12. Everything is known as a 1/2. See, ratio are similar in this way. The distance may be different. In this first case, distance is 1 meter and 2 meter. In the second case, distance is 3 meter and 6 meter. But ratio is exactly same for all those cases. Okay, so similar way, the situations are different. This situation says represents a drop, and this is just of any free falling body. But if you count this ratio of this S1, S2, S3, S4 in this first case or in the second case, your answer will be same. So what is this ratio? S1 is to S2 is to S3 is to S4 in this both case is equal to 1 is to 3 is to 5 is to 7. ओके तो फिर आपको क्या फाइंड करना है देखो तो फर्स्ट केस में आप अप्लाई करो तो आप ऐसा लिख सकते हो इन द फर्स्ट केस बाय कंपेयरिंग द सिचुएशंस आप ऐसा लिख सकते हो देखो 5/x मतलब कि ए टोटल डिस्टेंस अपॉन दिस वन सो यहां पे टोटल डिस्टेंस कितना हुआ देखो 5/x में टोटल डिस्टेंस यहाँ पे कितना हुआ तो यहाँ पे इज इक्वल टू ऐसा लिख सकते रेशियो सेम रहना चाहिए 5 + 15 + 25 + 35 अपॉन x में यहाँ पे कहाँ से कहाँ तक का है 1 से 3 तक का सो यहाँ पे वन से थर्ड तक का देखो, वन से थर्ड में क्या है, 35 प्लस 25, सो अपॉन 35 प्लस 25. सी आई एम जस्ट कंपेयरिंग द रेशियो, मीन्स वॉट आई एम डूइंग हियर, इन फर्स्ट केस एस वन प्लस एस टू प्लस एस थ्री प्लस एस फोर अपॉन एस थ्री प्लस एस फोर इज इक्वल टू, इन सेकेंड केस एस वन प्लस एस टू प्लस एस थ्री प्लस एस फोर अपॉन एस थ्री प्लस एस फोर. मैंने ऐसा कंपेयर किया आंसर. रेशियो में आप दोनों केस में सेम ले सकते हो, डिस्टेंस डिफरेंट होगा, रेशियो सेम रहेगा. ठीक है, एग्जैक्टली आई एम जस्ट राइट, वन बाई टू इज इक्वल टू थ्री बाई सिक्स इज इक्वल टू फाइव बाई टेन. ओके, सो लेट्स काउंट दिस आंसर. सो 5 अपॉन एक्स इज इक्वल टू 5 प्लस 15 20 एंड 35 प्लस 25, सो 35 प्लस 5 40, 40 प्लस 20 60, 60 एंड 20 80, सो दैट्स टोटल न्यूमरेटर इज व्हाट 80 अपॉन डिनोमेटर 5 5 10, सो 25 30 30 60, सो दिस वन. सो व्हाट इज एक्स हियर, सो एक्स इज इक्वल टू 0 0 कैंसिल आउट एंड 5 इंटू 6 अपॉन 8, सो आंसर इज वॉट एक्स इज इक्वल टू 5 6 30 अपॉन 8 मीन्स 15 अपॉन 4 मीटर. सो दिस इज द एक्स. सो दैट इज अ वेरी सिंपल मेथड टू गेट सोल्व आउट दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम. अदरवाइज दिस प्रॉब्लम इज नॉट सोल्व बाय अस, इट्स क्वाइट डिफिकल्ट टू सोल्व आउट. ओके, बट बाय यूजिंग दिस लॉ यू जस्ट सोल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम विद इन अ 1 मिनट. ओके, सो ऑल ऑफ यू गाइस नोट दिस एग्जाम्पल, देन आफ्टर वी आर जस्ट गो टू दिस नेक्स्ट. ओके, नॉट इट.